Good morning, students. Today I am going to talk about Introduction to Artificial Neural Network. This is the first unit of this course, Introduction to Artificial Neural Network. In this unit, we have covered fundamental of neural networks, model of artificial neuron, neural network architecture, learning method, taxonomies of neural network architectures and application. We start our topic from fundamental of neural networks, then we will cover model of artificial neural and then neural network architectures, and in the next class we will cover learning methods, taxonomies of neural network architecture and applications. So let's start. First, what is artificial neural network? So there are the three terms, artificial neural network. So first, what is artificial? So artificial is a thing that is made by the human, which is not present naturally. So it is called artificial. Now, second term is neural network. So what is neural network? So neural network is a biological representation of neuron in the brain. So now it is clear. Artificial means the thing that is made by the human, and neural network is a biological representation of neuron in the brain. So artificial neural network means a thing that is made by the human in such a way so that the machine behaves like a human brain. As human brain react, same the machine has also react. So now the term artificial neural network is derived from biological neural networks that develop the structure of human brain like this, similar to the human brain that has a neuron. So these are the neurons which are interconnected to one another. And similarly, in artificial neural network also have a neurons that are interconnected to one another in a various layers of the networks. And these neurons are also known as a nodes. So now, this is the difference between the biological neural network and artificial neural network. The above diagram shows the diagram of biological neural network, and here it is the artificial neural network architecture. So what is the similarities between these diagrams? So in biological neural network, the dendrites are represented as an input in the artificial neural network architecture. The cell nucleus in biological neural network is denoted as the nodes in artificial neural network. Similarly, synapses is denoted as weights in ANN, and axon in biological neural network is represented as an output in ANN. Now, so this is the basic architecture of artificial neural network. First is the input layer, second and third is the hidden layer, and the last one is the output layer. So in artificial neural network architecture, we have only one input layer which receives the inputs from the users, and there can be a more than one hidden layer. Like here in this diagram, there is a two hidden layers, hidden layer 1 and hidden layer 2, and there is only one output layer. So the function of input layer is just to accept the input or the features from the users, and the hidden layers are used to perform some functions on that features and predict the output at the output layer. For example, if we have a cat and a dog, and we want to classify when we give the picture, so it classified it is a cat or a dog. For that, user needs to give some features of the cat as well as the dog. So first, like the user give some features like eyes, hairs, colors, size. Many of the input features are sent by the user at the input layer. Based on these features are passed to the first hidden layer, and in this nodes the computations are performed. And all the nodes of the input layer are interconnected to every other layer which are present in the hidden layer. So the computation is performed. The output of the first hidden layer is then passed to the input to the second hidden layer. Here also computation performed, and finally the output will produce. Like here we give input features like eyes, color, voice, and and structure. So based on that, the output gives like whether it is a dog or a cat. So this is the basic architecture of artificial neural network. Now, what is input layer? As the name suggests, it accepts input in several different formats provided by the programmer. What are hidden layers? The hidden layer presents in between the input and the output layers. It performs all the calculations to find hidden features and the patterns. So as I said, what are input layers? It accepts several different formats provided by the programmer. Like if you want to predict a weather, if you want to predict a weather forecasting, then you have to give a features of weathers like month at July previous year, how many the rain is there. So based on that, these are the features. Like if you want to classify whether it is a cat or a dog, so you can give a full picture to the input layer of the ANN, and then based on the picture, the ANN or the CNN, which is the different type of neural network, convolutional neural network, is used to extract the features from that picture, and then computation is performed at the number of hidden layers and output produced like whether it is a cat or a dog. So this is the functioning of the hidden layer where all the computations are performed. In input layer, only the features are given. There is no computation performed on the input layer. Now, the third is the output layer. What is the output layer? So in output layer, the input goes through a series of transformation using the hidden layer. There are many number of hidden layers. So the output of the final hidden layer is finally reached to the output, and which finally results in output that is conveyed using this layer. The artificial neural network takes inputs and computes the weighted sum of the inputs and includes a bias. Now, what do you mean by the weighted sum of the input? Weighted sum of the input means here, this is the computation which is represented in the form of transfer function. This computation is performed at the hidden layer. So, what is this? Wi is the weight, xi is the input, and b is the bias. Now, first, what is weight? So, weight are showing the strength between the input node and the hidden layer. The input node and the hidden layer, the feature which is given to the hidden layer, how much strength of that feature. So, weight is actually used to find the strength between the link of the input node and the hidden layer node. Second is xi. What is xi? Xi is the input. So xi means if we have 10 nodes, so I is start from 1 to 10. So weight 1 into x1 plus y. Weight 1 means the weight of input node x1 with the hidden layer node. So, W1 into X1 plus bias. Now, what is bias? Bias is used to get the more accurate output. Suppose, if we do sum Wi into Xi and then we perform summation for all the nodes and we get the result 0. So, based on that 0, we cannot identify any answer. Therefore, we are using here a bias term. This bias term helps the users to get the output in a more accurate way. Therefore, bias is used here. So, this is the transfer function that should be used in the hidden layer for computation. Let me explain. So, now I think so you all understand that what is artificial neural network. It is just a computation model that is used to mimic the human brain. As human brain works, we want, the human wants that machine can also work like the human brain. Therefore, artificial neural network is one architecture or is one computational model that is used for that purpose. The main components of artificial neural networks are the hidden layer, input layer, and the output layer. Input layer is used to take the inputs from the feature. No computation is performed at the input layer. Second is the hidden layer. In the hidden layer, all the computations are performed by the hidden layer. The features that are coming from the input layer are fed as an input to the hidden layer where all the computations are performed. And the output of the hidden layer is passed as an input to the output layer from where we get the, and the user get the output. So this is the basic functionality of artificial neural network architecture. The weight is also there, which provides how much strength of the input node and the node connected to the hidden layer. So this is called the weight, and these are the references. Thank you.